Yo, hello again everybody. This time I'm gonna bring you a nice TvT from one of my recent ladder games. This is once again going to be a build order guide, and I'm going to provide you in this series now with like ideas on what you can open up with. So I'm basically, this is gonna be the content for now. So let's start with this game. Basically what I did here in this game is I open up with a normal supply depot. After that, I go straight into the barracks. After the barracks, I'm going to take the gas. And then, as soon as I have enough money, I'm going to take the other gas as well. So double gas opening it is in this TVT. The next step will be finishing the barracks, and always make sure that you build enough SCVs. That is very important. Orbital, Reaper, and the depot in front. You can fully wall off that way. And then, as soon as you have 100 gas, you pull 2 workers out of gas. You can maybe also pull more out of gas. It doesn't really matter at this point. I pulled 2 workers out of gas, 1 each, because it's like the easiest way, I guess. And then I make the factory. As soon as I accumulated 400 minerals, I'll go for a command center. But before that, I'm gonna make another Reaper after the first Reaper. That's the first Reaper, then the second Reaper, and then I'm gonna go for the command center. So the Reaper can scout for proxies. It killed the SCV, it sees this Reaper over here. So we can be sure that there's nothing crazy going on. You start a Hellion as soon as the factory is done, and then another Reaper. And as soon as you have enough workers on the minerals, you start putting workers back into the gas. So right around this time is where you put workers back into the gas and then also make a supply depot. You start a second Hellion as well as the starport. And then you can pressure with your Hellion Reaper force. You don't have to do it. But, I mean, sometimes it's good if you're confident, but you don't have to. And then after 3 Reapers, you get the reactor. You make a tech lab after 2 Hellions. And then, as soon as the starport finishes, and the base, you're gonna make gas. This gas could have been slightly faster, maybe. And then you start switching your add-ons, because you go straight into a Raven here. I'm gonna put my units defensively in case he's gonna try and like scout with his Reaper, because I still haven't killed it. And then I'm just starting tank marine production. Before I build a tank, I'm gonna build a Cyclone. This is gonna keep us safe against Banshee play. I'm also gonna build multiple Ravens, so after the first one I'm gonna make another one. And then I make the command center. So now the Cyclone here is always in the main to defend against Banshees. The Marines and the Reaper Hellion force you can somewhat keep at front. And then you can get some map control maybe with this force. And yeah, basically now you just take additional gases. You go up into a starport, a reactor on the starport. So you switch these 2 buildings as soon as you build 2 Ravens. And then you go into Viking production. That is very important. So you want to make Vikings, you want to go up to 6 Vikings, because 6 Vikings one-shot medevacs, they one-shot Vikings. So 6 is like a magic number. And then you just go into triple barracks as soon as you have the money. What is the most important thing right now is to spend the money on siege tank production, Viking production, and stim. You don't need to make Marines at this point. Making Marines out of this barracks is not gonna do anything, it's just gonna delay your infrastructure. So at this point I want to spend my gas on Vikings tanks and stim, and then I don't spend my money on Marines, but SCVs of course, always make SCVs, it's important. And then I go up to more barracks. So infrastructure has a higher priority than Marine production in this case, but as soon as I have reactors on my barracks and I have stim pack, that changes. Basically as soon as you have stim pack, you want to make Marines, because then it's like really nice, right? Right now Marines are practically useless because we only have 1 barracks and they don't have any upgrades. So you add on two barracks, you add on double eBay, that's the next step in the build, and you can take your third base. The Cyclone keeps you safe at home, the Reaper Hellion Force tries to get map control, and if he pushes out with like his units, then you can always take your Cyclone for the map control. You can always put your air units over here and like a Marine here to spot like Raven harassment, that kind of stuff is really annoying. So normally I would recommend at this point using the Cyclone for map control so he can't just be in front of your base. Like what I'm doing here is really annoying for him because he doesn't know if I'm attacking him or not. And then you just go up to three base, you make double eBay, and you go for a double reactor and more barracks as well. The way I do it, I always saturate my base first and then I add on another two barracks. So see here, as soon as I have 16 guys here, see? 16 guys basically, I'm gonna throw down two more barracks. That's right around the time I have money. Since I'm making Vikings constantly, it's a little later than his two barracks, but right around this time I want to make them. So now I finally have the full saturation, and now I'm gonna add on two barracks. There we go. And then I'm also gonna add on two gas, as well as a sensor tower, and double upgrades of course beforehand, and the armory. For the specific build order, I'm gonna link you the replay in the comment, I mean in the description. But I'm not gonna link you the build order guide yet because I'm not ready for it. I'm gonna write that down and release it one day after this build order guide is released. Otherwise you can just write it down the way you want, basically. Just remember the main things that I explained about in this video. I'm getting even more Vikings now because I want to be a little bit aggressive, but you can stop making Vikings and add some medevacs when you have like six of them. Basically, I want to see if I can push him a little bit. I'm confident, but that is not necessary. You don't have to be this confident. And yeah, I mean, now you make the fourth command center. Now you get the second factory. Now you get the armory. This is basically everything to the build order. After the fourth base, you can either go into double starport or three barracks. Three barracks is good if you have a lot of minerals, but if you have a lot of gas, and I don't have a lot of gas, I only have 300 and I didn't even start to upgrade, so I don't have enough gas to make more starports. So for me in this situation, I would go for double starport, three barracks and not double starport. Because I simply don't have enough gas, as you can see, as soon as my 1-1 is done, I'm gonna start 2-2, and that's gonna delay me significantly. So I'm gonna throw down this, because I simply don't have the money for air units for like double starport. See, I'm gonna get 2-2 right around now, and then I'm gonna get more barracks. But you can also go into more starports, like two more starports, get reactors on them, get a fusion core for liberator range, and stuff like that. In this game though, we had a lot of minerals, so I went for the 8 barracks and then I would eventually go into the triple starport. The plan, like the way triple starport works, is you get enough Vikings for map control and then you add some liberators for range. So like liberator tank can like beat everything basically. Liberator Viking tank is the main composition. Marines are simply for like map control. In this case though, if you want to see the end of the game, I'm gonna show you quickly. So I accidentally lifted both of my command center, which messed me up. He is in position now. I was busy fixing my command centers. And he gets into a really good position here. He does a lot of damage. Specifically because I'm not able to clear this off properly, because I don't have a liberator. So now what's going to happen is I'm going to try and break this. But because I'm so focused over here, I forget about this angle, and here he's gonna kill my command center even though he doesn't have any units. It's only like 16 marines and a tank. I could have defended that. So I got picked apart a little bit, but eventually I think I still won the game because I just had my marine production. There was also a liberator here that really messed me up. So yeah, I had my Viking force to get rid of that, and then I just made mass tank marine. And I didn't bother taking another base because I wanted to all in him here. So basically I needed to all in him here because I got punished for being out of position and lifting my command center basically. the push here. As you can see, it's gonna work because I have the Liberator. See, this is why Liberators are so good. This is why I eventually go into like mass air, mass Viking Liberators. It's because of this. There's just no way with full Marine tank to break this. There's absolutely no chance. I got caught off guard a little bit, but I still got plenty of energy on my Ravens. So therefore, they're gonna trade pretty well, even though I didn't take the fight perfectly. So I get rid of all tanks besides them. And these tanks I can simply get rid of by outmaneuvering them. So I just go to the left, go to the right, outmaneuver the tanks, even a small drop here. Then I just go in like this, and we get rid of the third base. So even though I got pushed back in my own third base, I am able to recover because I just went up to 8 barracks very fast, and I'm able to afford lots of marine production. And that's why, despite having less economy than my opponent, I'm still able to keep up with him pretty easily. And then I just pushed in, and yeah, we won the game here. I also have the upgrade advantage, I think. No, I don't, actually. So yeah, I didn't even have the upgrade advantage here. But I just win by having the better army. I can show you the army value. So this is like the army value. I have much more gas in my army. Even upgrades, so strong army for me. You just have a lot of tanks, but I have Liberator, so no problem. And yeah, that's it for this game. I hope you enjoyed this small tutorial. Once again, I'm gonna give you the guide, like the supply numbers and stuff in the description as soon as it's available. Probably takes a day, but I'm gonna link you the replay pretty much immediately. So if you enjoyed this one, and I'll catch you again to the next build order guide, which should come out in the next few days as well.